essentially this course is part of a broader effort to produce a curriculum, essentially at a perhaps a graduate student level. But the idea is to produce both in person and online an entire set of teaching materials across an entire field, which is Biodiversity and Informatics. Biodiversity and Informatics is an interesting field, partly because of its novelty, which is to say it's quite a young field. And that means, in large part, that there are no established comprehensive programs where you can go and get a full education in biodiversity and informatics. I know of individual programs that do individual sectors of biodiversity and informatics quite well, but I don't know of any program, for example, a doctoral program somewhere, that really has the faculty and the depth to give a full introduction to the field. What is more, there are not in existence comprehensive training materials, which is to say there's no textbook, there's no online set of information that gives you the whole panorama of what is biodiversity informatics. And at the same time, there's quite a need for this. All of you are aware of the concerns about biodiversity conservation, about natural resources management, all sorts of concerns wherein we really should be finding effective ways to understand and scope out and use and interact with the natural world effectively, which really puts a premium on effective implementation of this field of biodiversity and informatics. So I'll give you just a slight bit of background about where this program comes from. My basic assumption, so in some ways this course works against my basic assumptions, but my basic assumption is that a PhD is the best form of training. And so in general, I don't like capacity building workshops. I don't like short training courses. And so my biggest goal is to find ways to move those of you who are motivated and interested and excited enough to a PhD. Now, we don't have funding for that, so we end up coming short of that. But in my lab, I've been at the University of Kansas for 20 years now, and those are the places where my graduate students have come from. So you can see it's quite a global program. I've also taught short courses on aspects of biodiversity informatics in several countries. And then the real impetus for this program goes back about 6 years when I helped to organize and teach a series of four courses on ecological niche modeling. That funding was provided by the Global Biodiversity Information Facility, GBIF. And those courses were in Mexico, US, India, and Poland. In fact, Colmia was in one of those courses. And I had the honor of having him in my house, and he had the unpleasant experience of being in Kansas in one of the coldest periods that we've had in recent years. But the long and the short of it is, my own program is global, and even in spite of my assumption and my firm belief that graduate study is irreplaceable in terms of building capacity, I did see that these short courses and these training courses that I've been involved with over the years have been effective. And so that's kind of the antecedents to this project. So another aspect of antecedents to this program is that we have some interesting technology available to us. In-person work and interaction is always best, but we have some very simple technologies that can be very effective. And one of the most effective ones is simply the ability to share digital videos. And a very simple and very broadly available way of achieving that is by YouTube. We can go to any internet cafe in Nairobi, and we will have access to YouTube. I've been exploring in recent months, and I've come up with another bit of technology, which is a site called .sub, which essentially makes possible crowdsourcing of subtitles. So one of the things that we do is we, as immediately as possible, transcribe these lectures, and then we have teams of volunteers, and I hope that some of you here will help us as volunteers, where as you study a video, you also translate it, and it's quite a rapid process once the transcription is made. And so with some test videos, we've been able, within a week, to get videos subtitled in not just English, but French, Arabic, Chinese, Spanish, and Portuguese. And so the long and the short of this technology is that we can get a lot of content out globally very quickly, very efficiently. And so that's another of the antecedents of this program. And so the idea that several of us assembled was combining in-person training courses with capture of digital video for all of the content, publishing the video to YouTube, transcribing the English subtitles, and translating the subtitles in as many languages as we have volunteers, and then providing ancillary information, which might be copies of all of the presentations, relevant literature, etc. So that's the idea. Many of you probably know about the JRS Biodiversity Foundation, but it's one of the very few funding agencies that's dedicated completely to biodiversity and informatics. And so in January of 2012, I approached the foundation with a proposal for funding, and they funded it as of June of last year. And it's basically taken us these 7 months to get ready to begin these courses. We are, I think, positioned to give you all the in-person training and serve the digital content quite rapidly. We'll try to have everything up and online within a week or two. I will mention to you that the funding is bare bones, which is to say, we have just enough money to bring you guys in and the experts and house you and feed you. And I have partial funding for an assistant who is Kate Ingenbach. Actually, she's not even working for the project right now. She's looking for another grant. But we can, I think, piece together just enough funding for the assistant for the program. So, JRS was quite generous in funding this project, which is well outside of their usual sort of project. And essentially what we're setting out to do is to present a series of courses in a series of cities across Africa. There is introductory material which will be presented, at least a bit of it will be presented in each course, and some of it we probably won't take time to do in person. I've already prepared modules on how to publish scientific papers and how to prepare funding for proposals, and I don't think we're going to have time to do that in any of the in-person courses, but they're already prepared. But then we'll have, this is kind of in order of thinking, but we'll have a two-week course on capturing biodiversity data. That should be next January. You all are here for data cleaning and data publishing. And next week, here in CIFE, we'll do a course on ecological niche modeling. And then these last two will be in South Africa as of July of this year. So the idea is to cover all of these fields in sufficient detail to give the participants and the global participants an overview of the entire field of biodiversity informatics. That's basically what I just told you, but that's the general schedule. I would ask all of you the favor of essentially sharing your experiences with your companions and your colleagues back home so that we get another very good pool of applicants for the upcoming courses. So where is this going in the long term? This JRS course, a set of courses, is funded over 3 years. In the longer term, the idea is to extend this to other fields. We already have people interested in organizing follow-ons that would treat topics such as molecular systematics, taxonomy, public health applications, and others. Not very relevant to most of Africa, but we're organizing in-person courses taught across Latin America. And ideally, what I really want to do is to encounter funding for essentially a cooperative network of graduate training, essentially to provide fellowships to continue this, this initial training at a deeper level. So that's really where we want to go with the whole program. There's also an electronic journal that is available for discussions of this field. It is completely open access and completely free of any charges related to publication. And most of you are familiar with the Facebook page, which now links more than 640 people who have some interest in this field. Please pass around these links again to your colleagues and your peers back home. So that's a very short and simple introduction to the overall program.